Channel 2, Friday Night Football, WSBTV.com, yeah. I got my eye on the ring, we've been preparing forever. We will come out on top as a team, we're together. We've been in a weight room, hot sun, hard work, two-a-days. Shedding blood, sweat, and tears with my coaches and teammates. Friday night, high school football, yeah, we're under the lights. The biggest games of the season in the zone tonight. Rivalries, they run deep, classic battles on the field. Stands packed with the fans, I give my all right here. Cause in this moment, I gotta put all my heart in it till the game's finished and I got to win in position. The cheerleaders, the band, and supporters behind me. Our team is a family, got my brothers beside me. Channel 2 and live football on the screen tonight. All our favorite guys with the call on the mic. There's a chill up in the air through the roar of the crowd. You better bring your A-game, we protect this house. It's one goal, one championship you wanna claim. So leave your heart on the field and keep your head in the game. Get ready, Georgia, cause it's going down tonight. We worked all season long for the game of our life.
The Channel 2 Sports Zone has made its way to the Eagles' Nest at Milton High School, where tonight the 4-1 Eagles host the 5-1 Warriors of Cherokee High. Hello, everybody, and thanks so much for joining us alongside DJ Shockley. I'm Van Earl Wright. DJ, a couple of programs on the rise, as you saw with their records, but also on the rise because there's a lot of talent on both of these teams. Let's start with the visitors from Cherokee and the state's number one receiver in Andrew Harris.
When you talk about building a receiver, you want him to look somewhat like Andrew Harris. Talk about what he's done this year for Cherokee. He's just been outstanding. You see the numbers there at the bottom. They are just outstanding. He's done a great job, not only on the field, but off the field as well. Coach Shaw talks about his leadership. Talked about what he did this summer to get his body fully developed for this season. Three games this season, he had over 200 yards. Wow. Other three games, he had 10-plus catches. Wow. He has done an outstanding job catching the football and then making plays after he catches the football. If he does that tonight, they got a good chance of getting another W.
Well, it's been a breakout year for Andrew Harris. He had only 20 catches the entire season last fall. One of the guys on the Milton defense that will be trying to stop Andrew Harris is Quarte Sapp. He's been known to college recruiters for a couple of years now, and he's still living up to his billing.
Oh, he is a dynamic player. And when you talk about a game changer, you usually don't think about a linebacker being a game changer, but he is definitely that. He's going to be kind of on the other side trying to stop his high-powered offense of Cherokee, but if anybody can do it, it's Quarte Sapp. He's athletic. He's physical. He can run. He's all over the field whenever you see this Milton team play tonight, but he's going to have a tough task tonight of stopping a lot of weapons on the other side of the football. If anybody can do it, he can.
And the Milton offense certainly loaded as well as they begin and end with Miko Brisker, who we'll be telling you about throughout this game. Kickoff is coming your way between Cherokee and Milton right here in Alpharetta, Georgia, and we're glad you're with us.
Association, your crew members, coaches, and fans, we want to take this opportunity to say thank you for 38 years of outstanding service as a football official. Over the past 38 years, you have driven over 850,000 miles in horrific traffic, officiated over 1,800 regular season middle school, JV, and varsity games, and officiated over 100 playoff games, many in the Georgia Dome. You are very well known and respected by all coaches. We'd like to say thank you for your dedication, motivation, knowledge, enthusiasm, goodwill, good humor.
Back at Milton High School, and the colors of the Eagles are red and blue, but the majority of the students showing their purple tonight. And the story behind that is that a former coach, football coach for Milton High School, Mike Scott, passed away from pancreatic cancer a couple of years ago. And purple is the color to raise awareness for pancreatic cancer, much as pink is for breast cancer. And that's why a lot of the Milton kids are in purple tonight. Cherokee won the coin toss. They deferred to the second half. So Milton will start this game with the football as soon as it is kicked their way by Gary Dubiel. And Gary has a very strong leg, already 25 touchbacks this season through Cherokee's six games so far. We were ready for Gary to step into it, but apparently he wasn't. Cherokee at Milton, underway on a line drive kick, fielded at the goal line. That's Nathan Craner. He's got some running room and finally taken down to the ground right at the 35-yard line. Good field position for the offense of Milton. Their quarterback, Austin McLeod, a senior. He wears number 11. He comes in having completed 57% of his passes, but only a little more than 500 yards through the air because Milton is a run-first team. First and 10 from their own 35. The ball goes to Chris Turner, one of the Milton captains on the night, and he gets it out to the 40 and finally wrestled down by a host of Cherokee defenders.
Great first down run here for Milton, getting the football upside the field. You see picking up 4 or 5 yards on the stretch zone. Offensive line doing a good job of chasing everybody sideways and Turner getting upfield going north and south.
Chris Turner, number 7, described by his head coach, Howie DeCristofaro, as a slasher type of a runner, trying to slash for a few more yards, but he'll wind up 2 or 3 shy of the first down. It'll be 3rd and short for the Eagles.
You just said Turner's a slasher. Now you see number 33 coming into the ballgame, Miko Brisker, who coach calls is one of the strongest, the more physical. You see Coach Howie DeCristofaro there, head coach here at Milton High School, done really well for himself here. Had a lot of great athletes come out of Milton.
We will talk more about Howie as we continue as the jet sweep is handed to Obi Fortune across midfield, still on his feet, ready to break away, going for the end zone and finally wrestled to the ground. Bryson Perry with a touchdown saving tackle.
Got a flag right here on the 45-yard line. Looks like it's going to bring it back. Right when he turned up field to go north and south, you can see the referee throw the flag. So that's somewhere in the line. Holding, and you see the initial call there by the ref, holding, going to bring that spectacular play all the way back.
It was going to be a 51-yard gain for Obi Fortune, but it's coming all the way back thanks to that holding call signaled by our referee tonight, Jerry Kelly.
Big thing about that play, man, it was on third down. They had picked up the first down and then just the second effort to pick up 51 yards, but there's a reason why he was able to pick up those 51 yards because somebody was holding.
He's going to move the line of scrimmage back to the 35. It'll be third down again, but now it's third and long. McLeod from the shotgun, tucking and running, but taken down immediately by the nose guard, Jacob Harvey. A 6'3", 285-pound senior for the Warrior defense.
And he does exactly what Coach talked about. He protects the middle. They try to come with the QB draw, try to put Brisker on the outside to stretch his defense, come to quarterback draw. Good job with Jacob Harvey there solidifying the middle.
You see the disappointment on the face of the head coach, Howie DeCristofaro, as his team is forced to punt thanks to that holding penalty. Ethan Suda, a good leg, been averaging just shy of 38 yards a kick. Fielded cleanly by Montrell Washington. And decent field position for the Warriors of Cherokee for their first offensive series of the game. Their quarterback, number four, Spencer Ashley. 6'1", 205-pound senior, and he's come in red hot, having completed 72% of his 168 passes on the season.
Throwing the rock, Van Roo. That's what they do.
First down, little swing pass, but unable to be gathered in. Intended for Britton Brown, who's coming off a 122-yard performance last week. Also from number eight in white. He had a 285-yard performance earlier this season in a win against Wheeler.
You should have heard our coach was talking about Britton Brown, just saying how explosive he is, powerful, can catch, can run, just has the speed.
Ashley with the play fake and complete over the middle to Andrew Harris. There he is, number 10 in white, the number one receiver in the state of Georgia.
Look at the numbers. We talked about the numbers earlier in the open. But 918 yards, he had three games of over 200 yards. Once this guy catches the football, he does more than just catch it. He takes it the distance, 14 touchdowns on the season. He has one interception for a touchdown, too, so he knows how to get to the end zone.
And he's run in a touchdown, and he's also thrown a touchdown pass. Ball in the belly of Britton Brown. Plenty of running room across midfield, and the Warriors are on the move on their first offensive series of this game, all the way down to the 46 of Milton, a gain of 24 yards.
You see Britton Brown, the junior, he's got tons of offers. Coach says schools will look at him, a freakish athlete. He's going to add to those numbers tonight. You can tell he's a hard, physical, he gets upfield right now type of runner.
Brown continues to remain in the backfield with the quarterback, Spencer Ashley. Brown gets the ball again, not much there, up the middle for the Warriors.
Good job by Nick Steinhaus right there, number 96, who actually clogged up the hole right there. Good job of him making a good play in the middle. You talk about Nick Steinhaus, number 96, 5.5 sacks. You see Quarte Sapp, who we talked about in the open, one of the leaders of this defense. He's got four interceptions at linebacker, four. One to the house already. He's a versatile player.
He's also got a defensive score. He's also got a safety, as well as his team leading 51 tackles. Swing pass to Brown, threatening the first down marker. The Warrior offense looking good in their first series of the game, DJ.
You can see what the Warriors want to do already. They want to get their playmakers with the ball in space. They got Harris on the quick throw. They got, now they're bringing Brown out here on the jet toss kind of throw on the outside. I mean, it's a good job of getting the football on the outside on the swing pass.
Third and very short for Cherokee. Just underway here in Alpharetta, Georgia. Play action complete on the right side. That's Montrell Washington, his 19th catch of the year. Last week, he had a 52-yard touchdown catch.
And you see the theme of the night right there. You see quick, short passes, 220 yards. They're going to spread this football around. You've seen Harris, you've seen Brown, now you see Washington. Everybody gets into the mix on this offense.
Another first down, line of scrimmage at the 28-yard line. Brown with it up the middle. Not much there. Sapp in on that tackle, along with Michael Collins. And we've got another flag down right at the point of tackle. Jerry Kelly is our referee. Looks like the preliminary call is holding, and it looks like it's going to be against Cherokee.
What an excellent job, I thought, on that play was by number 56. He did a good job, Mike Collins, of squeezing that football down the line and forcing that. So good job of him forcing that football there. You got a personal foul that's actually on Milton,
wow.
Not on Cherokee, but on Milton. That's going to give them half the distance. It's going to pick up big yardage as they go into the red zone here now.
All the way down to the 19-yard line. All eight plays on this first drive for Cherokee have been positive for them. First and 10 at the 19. Ashley. Not much there. He tucked it pretty quickly there, DJ. I guess his first option was not open, so he just decided to run it.
Well, I think more than anything, that was more of a designed quarterback run. You can tell he didn't even look downfield too much. He took one step to give the perception of pass. And you see Steinhaus on the tackle there and the great season itself. 11 tackles for loss. Just saw the previous play. He had a big tackle for loss. He's done a good job getting upfield and being a stalemate for this offense, defense.
Steinhaus, also the leader in sacks for the Milton defense with 5.5. It's Brown gets the corner. Brown down the sideline. Oh, and just denied at the 1 yard line. Corte Sapp with a touchdown saving tackle. But Britton Brown's a good looking running back, a gain of 14.
And here's why Coach Shaw calls this guy a human highlight film. First, you're going to see him bounce this football to the outside and the speed. The speed to beat him to the corner. Missed tackle on the outside. Now watch this freakish move right here. That's just effort to get all the way into the end zone one more.
First and goal at the one. Going up the middle. The big bruiser of a running back, Jamori Fox, the ball carrier.
That's a big guy, too. You see him up trying to run up in the middle. He's one of the key guys, especially when they get down here in the red zone. They want to give him the football. Jamori Fox actually plays defensive tackle on defense, but they like to get him the football down here near the red zone. But I got a feel this ball is going to go to Britton Brown.
Instead, they fake it to Brown, and Ashley tries to get it in, but he's denied again. Corte Sapp with his second touchdown-saving tackle of this drive.
Our very own Zach Klein's not going to be happy about that. He loved the naked bootleg, and the naked bootleg did not work on that particular play. They did a good job. You're right. They did a good job of staying at home. You see Corte Sapp. I'm not sure he's really smart running at him. Big third and goal here, Van Earl.
Third and goal is correct. There's Brown over the top, but he might have been denied. No signal. And yes, it looked, oh, and a late flag comes flying in. But a huge hit. Brown went airborne, and then he just went through the spin cycle in the washer there.
No doubt about it, he went through the spin cycle. He thought he was going to go airborne and get into the zone. Milton had another plan for him. I mean, it's excellent effort, but it's also great effort from Milton's side. Watch this propel. Oh, man.
That was Sapp with another key tackle. The flag came after the play was over. Personal foul against Cherokee on a third and goal situation, and that will back them up to the 16-yard line.
I was going to be angry if that was going to be against Milton. That was a good play, but watch him propel himself over and getting met right there in the middle. What a play. It's hard to see the number on that play.
Lucas Nedza
Lucas,
with the big
hit. Good job of Lucas there. Getting in there and putting his face in there. Lineman. The spin cycle to happen.
So now it's fourth and goal, but from the 16-yard line for Cherokee. As they are all over the field in this initial formation. Nolan Donnelly is in at quarterback, and they stay with the formation. They were going to go for the slant pattern. Intended for Randall Martinez. Donnelly, the backup sophomore quarterback, in on that unusual set.
That's just bad instruction right there. That just did not work out for him. The play was drawn up right. I guess numbers made him feel like they could throw that or have that option. Just not a good play there. Now they turn it over on downs, not getting anything out of a big drive.
13-play drive, and it comes up empty, and Milton takes over at the 16, and another flag comes out to blow the play dead.
Bravehearts, pay attention. We need one of you to report to the press box.
And that'll back up the Eagles closer to their own goal line, back to the 11-yard line after the illegal procedure.
Penalty's going to be a procedure call against the Eagles.
Cherokee got the football and just marched right down the field, and then some good defense from the Eagles as well as a penalty. And the Warriors come away with nothing. Miko Brisker, the ball carrier, winds up in the hands of a Warrior defender.
Uh-oh, looks like they're giving the ball to Cherokee.
It looks like it's going to be Cherokee football, the initial call from the referees, and the players still scrambling for it. Brisker's helmet comes off, and indeed it will be Cherokee football. Costly turnover, not by 33 in white, but 33 in blue. Their stud of a running back, Miko Brisker.
I wonder if his forward momentum has stopped here. We're going to see how early his football comes out. And there's a football ripped out right there. That's the old move right there. Hold him up, and somebody else comes and rip it out, and that's exactly what happened. Good call. Good call by the ref there to get to see that football come out early.
I agree. I do not think that that the play was over or he had been stopped.
Yeah, his forward momentum wasn't stopped yet. They were still fighting for extra yards, so.
Golden opportunity for the Warriors after the gift of a turnover. Back to Britton Brown. He is a strong running back. It's going to take more than one defender.
But look who's
to
on top of
that guy all night long. And there you go, 14 in blue again.
Yeah, Quarte Sapp, whenever that football is somewhere on this field, you can find 14 around it. He's a guy who's going to be around that football regardless if it's in the air or it's run. It's going to be an interesting matchup seeing 14 versus number 8 tonight.
Quarte came in as Milton's leading tackler with 51. Ashley on the move to the right, to the end zone, and knocked away. Good defense that time by Lucas Nedza. His second play, big play at the goal line for the Eagles.
Yeah, that's a great job of breaking his football up. Good timing on the play by Spencer, that throwing the football. But the last possible moment, you see him, Lucas, getting that right arm in there to knock that football away without getting a PI as well.
Milton looking good defensively so far. Showing they're up to the challenge to slow down this very high-powered Cherokee offense.
Big third down here. Looks like they're going to call timeout. Cherokee's going to call timeout to talk about this, but they got to come away with something here. They got to come away with a big, big play.
Josh Shaw in his third year at Cherokee, and boy, he has really turned around this program of the Warriors. They had some down years. He's come in, and now he's got them at 5-1, and kind of one of the surprises in Class 6A so far this year.
Yeah, one of the surprises, and this is one of the marquee games that Coach kind of said, hey, on our schedule, this is where we match up. We got to match up well versus a Mill team who's kind of had our number over the years, and they got to come in and show, hey, we can play with the top-tier teams in our region.
Cherokee has lost 5 in a row to Milton. Another big third down situation. They can still get a first down. They got to get down to the yard and a half line. Right now it's 3rd and 9. Ashley, show and throw, puts it in Britton Brown's belly. And he is stopped by Michael Collins.
They give the misdirection of they're going to throw something to the right side and bring Britton Brown around the backside to try to trick him with some kind of confusion. But Mike Collins stays at home being disciplined. That's what you want out of your senior defensive end. They're playing to run really well early in this football game. You got to see. You got to wonder if they got to get 3 out of this now. After the turnover, they got to get something out of the turnover.
Absolutely. Gary Dubiel, the senior kicker, 2 for 4 in field goals so far this year. And he goes 2 for 5 as he misses the target. And on a second straight possession, Cherokee comes away with nothing. Big boost to Milton's morale.
Disappointing here. Disappointing. They got 2 chances to get into the end zone and don't do it. And you see the score by quarters. Usually Milton outscores everybody 55-0 in the first quarter. They haven't had the ball much in this first quarter, but they've outscored all their opponents in every quarter pretty much.
Quick throw to Obi Fortune on the left side. He makes a good run after the catch. But he looks shaken up after the tackle.
Got
and a Cherokee player down as well on the Milton bench.
Injury timeout.
Looks like Griffin Moon, that is, who's down, number 3. Looks like he's the player that's down on the sideline. Maybe got the wind knocked out of him, but hopefully he's all right.
Jess is pleased to introduce Moon, one of the four captains for this game for the Warriors.
Nick Steinhaus,
a senior
Rick
linebacker.
Collins, Tyler Watson, Marty Horan, and Quarte Sapp.
And he looks all right. And there you see a good Jay look Mouse, of head coach Josh Paul, Shaw.
AJ Beach,
good to see him run and go off the field. You see Coach Shaw, his record is, you know, hasn't been what you want, but this season has definitely been a turnaround. We talked about him in 5-1, being having a good season so far and having some big signature wins already. They talk about last week beating Woodstock. Coach called it was a signature win for him, kind of a measuring stick, if you can say so. So they're looking forward for another win versus, like we mentioned, Milton, who has had their number pretty much last 4 or 5 years.
Last five meetings. All Milton.
Eagles.
Quarterback Austin McLeod takes the shotgun snap.
Ball carrier number
hands
seven,
it off
Chris
to Turner.
This is this
good game yards. Up the middle on first down.
See Chris Turner's yards here. He's a big physical back as well. Almost 300-some yards rushing the football. Big, strong, physical slasher type of back, but you see what Milton's trying to do now. They're trying to control this clock with the run game.
Now they're looking for the air. McLeod rolling to his right. He has a man wide open. Obi Fortune behind the coverage. Obi Fortune is off and running, and he is in for the score.
Great play by on the quarterback, Austin McLeod. Good job of throwing the football. Nice touch pass. Not getting too excited. Sometimes you can do that when a guy is that open. Obi Fortune making a great play on it. You see the two guys congratulate each other. That's a good job of making a play. We just talked about how they outscored their opponents in the first quarter. It was only a matter of time before they got on the board.
66-yard touchdown pass. McLeod to Fortune. And on for the PAT is Ethan Suda as another flag comes out.
An encroachment penalty against the Warriors. That penalty will be declined.
That scoring drive by the Eagles took just three plays and took less than a minute off the game clock. So they weren't able to chew much clock, but they got the receiver wide open behind the secondary. Suda's extra point try is up, and it is good. So with a little more than 3.5 minutes to go here in the first period, the home team jumps out to a 7-0 lead thanks to a 66-yard TD toss. You're watching Friday Night Football on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery.
Got a mic over there or something? Can you hear those coaches talking over there? I swear I hear them
and
coaches
fans,
talking.
Compliments of Jet Pizza. Our special team starters, our kicker is Ethan Suda. Our punter tonight is Lane Allison. Our long snapper is Ryan Wilson. And our kick returner is Nate Craner. Let's get Jets. Back deep to receive the kick, number 10, Andrew Harris, and number 28, Montrell Washington. Kicking off for the Eagles, number 12, Ethan Suda.
Milton breaks the seal on scoring. Back to receive the kickoff, Andrew Harris, number 10, and Montrell Washington, number 28. Kicking it away for the Eagles, Ethan Suda. Good high kick. Washington fields it at the goal line. Cutting to his left, still on his feet, looking for some blocks. And finally taken down at the 24-yard line, and another flag comes in after the play is over.
Yeah, you'll get a block in the back right there. You saw it at the end of the play, get a nice block in the back there, so they're definitely going to take that back. They give them some pretty bad field position to start this drive off. The Cherokee hasn't had a problem moving the football.
They're their own worst enemy right now.
Once they get inside the red zone, that's when they begin to stall.
But you got to credit the Milton defense. They have made at least three good plays at the goal line to deny Cherokee the end zone. Penalty against Cherokee.
Going to go against the Warriors.
Here again is the TD toss from McLeod to Obi Fortune.
Look at McLeod get his shoulder squared to the line of scrimmage and throw that football with some good touch. Obi Fortune doesn't have to do much but just catch it and roll into the end zone. Great call, great play. Good job of them executing that play, getting the big touchdown.
First and 10 for the Cherokee Warriors. Line of scrimmage, their own 12. Ashley taken down in the backfield. First man there, Marty Horan, a senior defensive lineman. That's his, where he now has 3.5 sacks on the year.
That's a play they like to use a lot. We saw it in the first series. They fake the draw action, and they want to get Harris coming right behind where the linebacker suck up at, but they never moved. They stayed home, and it wasn't there, which caused a sack. So good job up front of the front four, causing some stir up front, get some pressure on Spencer Ashley.
Line of scrimmage just inside the 10-yard line. Britton Brown, the ball carrier again for the Warriors. A modest gain gets it out to about the 12.
I think this is where Milton likes to pick. They want to keep this offense third and long. They know they want to throw the football. They know how well Spencer Ashley has thrown the football this season. They want to get him in throw third and long situations and make him force the football down the field. Maybe they can come up with a big turnover.
Third and 10. Ashley not finding anybody open and taken down as another flag comes in from the referee behind the play. No doubt going to be a holding call on the Warriors.
Tackles in the backfield. Making the tackle, number 56, Michael Collins. Flag on the play. It's a holding penalty against the Warriors.
Milton declines the penalty. So it'll be fourth and 10 for the Warriors. Cherokee, on their first drive of the game, looked very good. But right now, the Milton defense is definitely in control of the Cherokee offense.
And Milton didn't bring a blitz at all. That was all done by the front four up front. The front four up front guys have 10.5 sacks on their own without any pressure. So that's a good job of them beating the five offensive linemen. And a good job of coverage on the back end, because that could have been a coverage sack as well.
Obi Brandon is the Cherokee punter, kicking from his own end zone. And only gets it out to the 35-yard line, so excellent field position upcoming for Austin McLeod and the Milton offense.
Yeah, momentum starting to change already in the first quarter as we get down near the end of this first quarter. Milton is starting to take over. You see the field position game is changing. Milton's trying to feel a little bit better after that big touchdown. Now they get a defensive stop. They're starting to settle in here early in this first quarter.
Nico Brisker, the lone running back for McLeod. Brisker gets the football. Good blocking on the right side and gets it down to the 30-yard line.
Staying ahead of the chains is big for him. You see Miko Brisker there. They got a lot of running backs. You talk about him being the downhill, run through you, very strong type of running back in the backfield. Miko's tough running the football. We've seen him last year. He's hard to bring down.
Quick throw on the right side to Obi Fortune. Picks up the first down on the run after the catch. The Milton Eagles are once again moving the football. More on Brisker. Well, there's Obi Fortune, the number one receiver, as you can tell, for the Eagles. Came in with 17 catches. And already tonight has his third TD catch of the season. Brisker, the ball carrier, down to the 22-yard line. I was about to say, Miko, number 33, an accomplished weightlifter, as you see some of these numbers. I mean, these numbers are
off the charts.
Man, I just saw you do that the other day, so this is not too bad, right? I've seen you squat this.
You know, I was going to keep that quiet because I'm so modest, but I really appreciate the love.
Yeah, Miko's really strong, man. Coach Howard DiCaprio talked about how strong he is.
I don't know what was going on there, but everybody was moving except the football.
If you look at Miko, though, you see the tree trunk legs. You can see why he can squat 645 pounds and why he can clean a lot. He's a good-looking running back.
Quite a weightlifting program here for the Milton football team because their head coach, Howie DeCristofaro, man.
He's an Olympic weightlifter himself.
He's coached seven Olympic weightlifters.
Miko actually has six world records.
Not Olympic, I shouldn't say for DeCristofaro, but he has coached when he was coaching in Florida. Seven state weightlifting champions in the Sunshine State. And you were saying Miko has some world records.
Miko has six world records. He's competing in the national powerlifting. He's done a great job as the first quarter comes to end. Milton up seven.
You're watching high school football on the Channel 2 Sports Zone. WSBTV.com. End of it should be second quarter.
It's Milton football and it's second and 13.
Back at the Eagle's Nest, Milton High School in Alpharetta, Georgia. Along with DJ Shockley, I'm Van Earlwright. As the home team faces a second and 13 from the 28-yard line.
We'll take easy yards. That's what Milton says. We take easy yards. Van Earl doesn't like this type of ball game, but I love it. As a quarterback, you can get him to jump off sides. That's what I'm about. Get easy yards so you make it a bit easy on yourself here on second down. You got a whole gamut of plays you can call right now.
Gamut. Thank you. Second and seven from the 23. Brisker, the ball carrier. Up for the challenge of slowing him down, the strong safety, Asher Davis, head-to-head. Asher came in with 50 tackles on the season. And one interception.
Yeah, Asher's a guy, Coach A. He's a track guy, can run, but we're going to see him mostly in run support as he was right there. The good open field, sure tackle of Miko Brisker, one-on-one.
Tackle for a loss. His third of the season. Oh, McLeod going for Will Bond, a senior.
He had him, too. He had him wide open, run a 12-yard curl. Just a little high on the throw. He brings that down. They got a completion for a first down. But also, if Emmanuel Lucas, number 21, a defensive back for Cherokee, doesn't slip, that's a pick going the other way.
Ethan Suda on to try a 40-yard field goal.
Whoa.
Oh, look at the strength of that leg.
Whoa.
Way through the uprights and good for 3 points. Ethan Suda with his fifth field goal of the season, giving his team a 10-point lead early in the second quarter. All Milton so far. High school football from the Channel 2 Sports Zone.
That was a boomer. You can get home.
That guy, that was good from 55.
Easily, right? Sucker was high?
No. It wasn't 38 yard. It was a 40 yarder.
Yeah, because he was on the
ball,
30.
The ball was at the 30. But you got the 10 yards of the end zone. That's a 40 yarder. It was a 40-yard field goal.
All you got to do is look down at where they're holding it at. That's how you gain what it is.
So it doesn't go from the line of scrimmage?
No, not for field goals.
Okay.
So, like, where they're holding it at, they're at the 30, at 10:40.
Saw a shot of Pete DeWeese, the defensive coordinator for the Milton Eagles in his third year in that role, seventh year coaching here at Milton. That kick from Ethan Suda could have been good from 55 yards.
That was impressive.
Number 12, Ethan Suda. Back deep for the Warriors, number 10.
Looking to see this Cherokee offense, see if they can get back on track. They start the game moving the football. Last couple series, not so much.
Suda into the end zone and an automatic touchback. So Cherokee will have it first and 10 at their own 20. And their quarterback, number 4, Spencer Ashley.
Yeah, we haven't seen his high-powered offense that we expected to see coming to this game, averaging over 40 points a game, putting up a whole bunch of yards. We haven't seen much of it. Last week, he was 21 of 33 for 436 yards and 4 touchdowns.
That's amazing.
So he can throw the football. He can sling it, but his Milton defense is really up to the task right now.
Second game with more than 420 yards for Ashley. First and 10, they stick to the ground game. Brown, still the ball carrier. He's stopped behind the line by a host of Eagle defenders. So another negative play on their first series before they got stalled in the red zone, DJ. All of their plays were positive now. Seems like every play since then has been negative.
Well, two things they got to do. They're trying to establish the run game, but that's not happening. What they got to do is get that football out of Spencer's hands quickly. When they try to throw the football down the field, that's when they got the sacks. Throw the ball quickly, get it on the outside to the perimeter, and allow those guys to make some plays and get positive yards.
Don't forget, Cherokee has the state's leading receiver, number 10, Andrew Harris. Good pocket that time, but Ashley's throw way off the mark. And obviously Milton is very aware of number 10 in white, Andrew Harris.
Yeah, good pressure.
But Ashley is not looking for him at all.
Good pressure by number 52, Isaiah Hawkins, getting the pressure on Spencer Ashley right there. And I just don't feel like Spencer's comfortable in the pocket right now. He seems a little on edge because they're getting some pass rush on him. You see where he ranks in the state, Andrew Harris, receiver number 10. He's done a good job this season. He's not close to the second. He's not even close to him. But he hasn't had much to talk about tonight.
Third and 10. Good pressure on Ashley, and it goes down. Nice tackle. Number 96, Nick Steinhaus, now with 6.5 sacks on the season, came in as the Milton leader in that category, a loss of 11 yards.
This is what you call a meeting at the quarterback, Van Earl. That's exactly what that was. You see three guys back there, and that Spencer had no chance. He tried to get outside the pocket. He had no chance. That's just a good job of the defensive line saying, hey, I'm going to beat you, beat the guy in front of me. Offensive line, they have to do better for Cherokee, especially if they're going to throw the football.
Obie Brannon is the Cherokee punter. Back deep to receive is Nate Craner. He signals fair catch. And it'll be Milton football at the Cherokee 40-yard line. And yes, DJ, as you pointed out, the field has definitely flipped in the favor of the Eagles.
Yeah, it hasn't been good for Cherokee at all. They've had great field position starting in their territory majority of this game already. Short fields always equal points majority of the time, and they definitely turned them into 10 points.
First and 10 for the Eagles. Quick throw by McLeod, but knocked down by one of the pass rushers for Cherokee. That's number 33, Adam Mayo, a junior who plays the position they like to call bandit, which means you're a hybrid between defensive lineman and linebacker.
A lot of guys are that, you know, on the next level now. That's what you see a lot of players are, who are a little in-between type of guys.
Second and 10 for Milton. Pump fake, going for Craner. Threw it to his back shoulder, but Craner could not bring it in. Defended by Jack Carroll, a sophomore free safety.
You see a lot of guys try, you see a lot of teams try this screen and go, but a good job of staying at home. Number six, Nick Jack Carroll, did a good job staying at home. You see 41 tackles on the year, an INT, gets another pass deflection there. A good job of him not really going for the fake of the screen pass and breaking on the football.
Carroll was the starting point guard for the Cherokee basketball team last winter as a freshman. Oh, he's still on his feet. Good run up the middle by Chris Turner. Down inside the 25-yard line, a gain of 15 yards for Turner.
Nothing but a hard physical run. That's determination here at the end to run the football. Good hole up front. He doesn't get touched. He's 8 yards down the field, and just the extra effort right there is huge for Milton and brings up a good first down. Milton on the move.
Absolutely. Milton looking to add to their 10-point lead. Still early second quarter. Turner, the ball carrier, moving the pile. Cherokee defender lost his hat. That's the middle linebacker, Mason Bailey. Turner getting some good blocking up front and taking advantage of it.
Line of scrimmage has just changed, Vanderall. You look at this offensive line, they're just dominating the defensive line right now of Cherokee. And you see the hurry up. Offensive line, defensive line of Milton is just dominating both sides.
Second and two. Brisker, the ball carrier, inside the 15. And yet another first down for the Milton Eagles, and yet another late flag coming in after the play is over.
They're going to have to bring these guys together in a minute if you get another personal foul.
On Cherokee, frustration starting to bubble at the surface for the visiting Warriors in the white jerseys and red pants.
Yeah, just not what you want when you need a stop, not what you want when you're trying to get back in this ball game. You're only down 10-0 right now. You got to try to hold them to a field goal and keep it at a two-possession game. But it's not helping yourself getting these big PI and personal foul penalties.
First and goal from the 7. Turner, the ball carrier. Turner denied at the goal line. No, he was able to break the plane. The linesman signals touchdown. And just what DJ said, Cherokee could not afford. Turner makes them pay with the second touchdown of the game for the Eagle offense.
Cherokee's not doing herself any favors. We talked about the field position game. We only have 40, maybe 30 yards to go each drive. It makes it easier on you. You got your whole offense to call, and Milton is executing right now at a high level.
Ethan Suda, no problem with the PAT. So with 8.5 minutes to go here in the first half, all Milton all night long. They lead it 17-0. Friday Night Football on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Well, damn it. Like to thank and recognize I want a game. I don't want to blow out. Did you hear what I said? Make that happen, Andrew.
We had,
let's go.
We had that Jeep Rally speed for those first couple games.
Yeah.
As the premier HVAC and air quality professionals. Air Control is a proud sponsor of the Milton Eagles football team. Go Eagles from Air Control. Drive like a champion. Palmer Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Ram. Palmer Dodge is proud to serve the area with quality Dodge, Jeep, and Chrysler vehicles. Located on Highway 9, Palmer Dodge is your full-service dealer. Palmer Dodge is Scott Strong, and a proud supporter of Milton High School football. Go Eagles!
Dun, 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 dun.
Back deep for the players, number 10. Andrew Harris and number 28, Montrell Washington. Kicking off for the Eagles.
17 to nothing. With more than 8.5 minutes to go in the first half. Ethan Suda kicking it away, but going out of bounds this time. So, better field position for the Warriors. And if you are the Warrior offense, like their quarterback, Spencer Ashley, DJ, what are you telling your teammates in the huddle?
He just got to ask his whole line to just protect for a half a second longer. He's not having any time to even look down the field. They're not getting any push up front in the run game. They got to find ways to get the ball on the perimeter earlier. Quick slants, quick hitches, tunnel screens, anything to get the football out of his hands on the perimeter right now is something his offense is going to have to do. They can't drop back down and throw the football down the field. They just don't have the time right now. Until they can establish some type of run game, everything's going to have to be quick.
First and 10 from their own 35 after the kickoff went out of bounds. Sticking with the ground game, nothing there. Brown fighting for all two of those yards on his own at the line of scrimmage, stacked up. What are you laughing at?
You said all two. Hey, but that's a good thing. It's positive. Last few drives, every time they started on first down, it was behind the chains. Now they're doing a better job of staying in front of the chains. Maybe they can get something going here. Stack formations at the top and bottom.
Second and 9. Play fake. Complete. A little hitch pass to Montrell Washington. Thrown to the ground by Devin Wilkins.
Nice shot by Devin on the outside. He was actually getting blocked by a receiver in Montrell Washington. Well, Montrell Washington running the football. Number 22, Colton Rosansky actually was trying to hold the block, but good job of number 21, Devin Wilkins, shedding the block, doing a good job this year. You see 15 tackles, 2 tackles for loss, and an interception. So he's a durable guy on the outside for the senior-laden team, and he's a senior as well.
Third and 7. Ashley rolling to his right. Short receiver is Washington, and he's short of the first down, taken to the ground. Number 40, your tackler.
I know they didn't pick up a first down there, but because they had the big penalty on the kickoff and they moved it, you know, 6-7 yards, now they're going to flip the field a little bit, and now Milton won't have as great a field position as they had previously. This is the start in the right direction.
Cherokee's punter is
4th and 3.
But
I
you
have
need
to
more.
Kick it again.
You need more. You're right. Kicking it is not good, but you need more.
Obi Brandon back to kick. Good kick that time. Fielded by Nate Craner on the run. Makes a sliding catch.
Safe.
Safe. At the plate.
Hey, you do what you got to do to catch the football. He secured the football. Great job of securing the football on the punt, giving them some good field position at 30. Not the usual that they've had in plus territory, but good start for Milton here. Can Cherokee stop this offense now? Since beginning of that second quarter, they haven't really stopped this Milton offense. They've done what they wanted to do offensively.
That is for sure. 6:32 remaining in the first half. Milton takes over again, first and 10 at their own 30-yard line. McLeod looking to the bench for play instructions. Miko Brisker in the backfield with Austin McLeod, the quarterback. Play fake to Brisker. Over the middle, he's got a receiver. That's his tight end, Jake English, with his fifth reception of the season.
Yeah, Coach talked about how well he catches the football. He's good blocking. He's better in the run game. But this is him stretching the football field. Good throw down the middle of the seam. That's a good football play there. Good job of Austin McLeod throwing the football.
15-yard gain. Little hitch pass to Craner on the right side. He takes it into Cherokee territory. Another positive play, but still shy of the first down for the Eagles.
And that's what I talked about for Cherokee. They can get things going like Milton is doing, getting that football out. You see Nader Craner there doing a good job of senior this season, averaging almost 10 yards a catch.
Second down.
Moving the football, getting the ball to their players in the open field.
Second and five. Craner, the ball carrier on the jet sweep, has the first down and gets it down to the 41-yard line.
Positive yards after positive yardage. Good job of getting on the perimeter. That's one thing that Cherokee's doing, that not doing a good job of, is allowing them to get to the perimeter. They're not setting the edge at all. They're just allowing Milton to get around the corner each and every time they run that jet sweep type of action.
First and 10 now at the 41-yard line for the Eagles. Handoff to Miko Brisker, right side. Takes on a couple of defenders, wrestled to the ground
Miko Brisker
by Brandon Johnson.
On the tackle, number 34, Michael Bean.
This is a Milton defense. I mean, it's a Milton offense that's steadily just starting to get better and just looks like they're trying to wear down this Cherokee offense, going to perimeter, going inside, outside zone, different types of backs. You've seen Miko, you've seen Chris Turner. They've seen a little bit of everything from this offense.
Pass complete to Obie Fortune on the right side. Gets it inside the 35-yard line. It'll be third and short for the Eagles.
Big third down play here. Cherokee has to bow his neck right now. They got to say, we need a stop right now. We can't allow them to pick up another first down, take more time off the clock, and leave it away from our offense. Big third down if you're Cherokee right now. Find a way to get a stop.
Brisker in the backfield, English in motion. Brisker, the ball carrier, wide open hole up the middle. Brisker still on his feet and all the way down to the 11-yard line. And there you see the power and the strength of number 33 in blue.
That's where you squat 645. You can just run over a guy. Look at the power here at the end to finish this run. That's just relentless effort and strength. That's something you can't coach. You either got it or you don't, and Miko has that extra strength.
Just destroyed Bryson Perry. Turner, the ball carrier now. From the power of Brisker to the slashing and darting of Turner.
Difficult to guard against. Difficult to guard against because they have two different type of backs. One is quick, one is shifty. One is strong, one is physical. They got a good combination here. We've seen some good backs this season, but Miko and Turner are total opposites when you talk about toting the rock.
And now Miko back in the game for the Eagles. McLeod, the ball carrier, and hit hard by Michael Bean, the leading tackler for the Warrior defense. He had 19 last week in Cherokee's win. He's going for a third consecutive 100 tackle season, is 34 in white.
There's a different dimension we haven't even talked about tonight, is Austin running. He looked very elusive on that particular play. They get him on the edge as well. He's a mobile quarterback.
Brisker taken down in the backfield. Nice penetration, nice play by Michael Bean, his fifth tackle for a loss.
Michael Bean, we haven't talked much about him tonight, but he's one of the leading tacklers as well, 79 tackles. You see the stat line. Coach talked about him being a good leader. He's smart, heady, versatile, can cover in space. You see him when they get outside and they want to stretch the field. He's that type of guy, but that's a big, big stop on third down when I talked about last few plays ago.
So Suda on for his second field goal attempt. This one a 26-yarder, and that kid has one strong leg, and it breezes through the uprights. So with 2:32 to go here in the first half, Milton increases their lead to 20 points over the visiting Warriors of Cherokee. High school football on WSBT.com.
Alpharetta Convention and Visitors Bureau can help you plan an awesome local event for your wedding, reunion, or meeting for free. The Alpharetta Convention and Visitors Bureau is pleased to present this Milton's awesome Eagle story. Senior Will Bond is a wide receiver for the Milton football team. Will has a 3.8 GPA and scored 1980 on the SAT and 28 on the ACT. Will is currently taking 3 AP classes and has already taken 4. Will,
last scoring drive by the Eagles, 9 plays in 4 minutes of game action, capped off by a 26-yard field goal from number 12, Ethan Suda. Suda just a junior kicker, DJ, but man, he ought to be on the radar of a lot of recruiters with a leg that strong.
Yeah, he's got a bright future ahead of him. He's done a good job of kicking the football tonight. He gets the ball up really high, so when you think about getting the ball up high, he wards the way people trying to block it. And he has a strong, strong leg. I want to see him try one from further out.
Me too. The way this Milton offense is going, it looks like he'll probably have a good opportunity. But for a second straight time, his kickoff goes out of bounds. So he's got to work on his accuracy on the kickoffs.
Yeah, if you got one thing to say, other than that, he's done a good job tonight. And I'm sure they're trying to angle some footballs in the corner or something, and he's just not keeping it in play. But Cherokee got 2.5 minutes to give themselves some confidence going in at halftime. You got to remember, Cherokee's going to get the ball at halftime. So to go down and get a score here and then get the football back at halftime would definitely feel pretty good going in half, especially the way you played in this first half so far.
Cherokee came in averaging 39 points a game. They even scored 54 a couple of weeks ago. Twice as many passing yards as yards on the ground for the Warriors, yet they continue to stick to the ground game. Tackle that time made by Michael Collins on Britton Brown.
It's just strange that they continue to go to this ground game and it's not working. They're not getting any penetration. I mean, Milton's getting a lot of penetration, but they're not moving the line of scrimmage at all up front. And it's just a tough sled for this Cherokee offense. It is not what you expect to come into the ball game with a high-flying offense that they have.
As well as the state's leading receiver in Andrew Harris, who has split out far wide up top. Ashley with the swing pass. Complete to Vance Taylor. Good run after the catch. Good blocking on that play by the talented receiver, Harris.
You talk about Harris, but also Dante Baker, number one. He was a big reason why that play got to the corner. He had a nice solid hit on the outside, but that's the type of plays that I talked about, getting the football out of his hands, getting in the perimeter now, allowing these guys to run.
Third and 5 for the Warriors. Ashley not finding anybody open. Throws a desperation pass to Taylor at the last second to avoid the sack. That's pretty good play, actually. But again, on third down, not getting it done. They came in, as mentioned, producing a lot more offense. And you see the frustration on the faces of the coaches and the players on the Cherokee sideline.
And it's, just to put this in perspective, Spencer Ashley has had 2 consecutive games where he's thrown more than 420 yards. He surpassed 5,300 yards. So for them not to be able to throw the football down the field is so surprising.
Well, the fair catch signaled by Nathan Craner. And with 1:24 to go, Milton will once again have the football. First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
You got a minute 24 to go. They've shown they can throw the football. Milton showed they can take some chunk plays and throw the football down the field by the big play by Obi Fortune, especially in the first half, in the first quarter, excuse me. I think Milton wants to get some more on this scoreboard before we go into halftime.
Well, considering who their kicker is,
you're right.
Maybe just get it down to the 40-yard line of Cherokee.
No doubt about it.
Chris Turner, the ball carrier on first down, picks up 4 yards on the left side.
About 4 yards on the play.
Yeah, they still got 3 timeouts to go in the first half, in this first half, so they got plenty of time with a minute to go. They're going to go to the air here.
McLeod with the pump fake. Got a man wide open behind the defense. Oh, my goodness. Will Bond could not stay in bounds. Otherwise, he was headed to the end zone. And right now, after this 36-yard gain, the Eagles are in field goal position.
Yeah, they went stop and go, Banner. It was simple 5-yard hitch, and then he goes. And looks like he got a cramp on the outside. But they went stop and go, and he was beat from the jump street. Devin Wilkins went for the fake, and it's a good job of them throwing it deep. You knew they were going to take a chunk play. We've seen it. Stop and go. Good connection.
That's Emmanuel Lucas down on the field, as DJ mentioned. Looks like he's dealing with some cramp issues right now.
And watch, you can see the stop and go action there. He just picks the outside receiver and a good job of completing that football. If he left him a little bit inside, he probably walks into the end zone. But a good job of Austin McLeod just giving him a chance to catch the football with him being so open.
Emmanuel Lucas walking off the cramp. Don't forget to stick around at halftime. Zach Klein and the AJC's Michael Carvel, their recruiting expert. We'll have a lot of recruiting news concerning those three players, all of whom are expected to sign with Georgia.
There you go, Van Earl. Say it again.
The Bulldogs.
Where are they going?
The Bulldogs. I'm about to give you love, so you better back down. The Bulldogs recruiting continues to be stellar. I mean, the freshmen that the Bulldogs are playing so far this season have really impressed.
No doubt about it. They play well, and you can see they got a lot of kids out here who could probably play on the next level as well.
Pass complete to Obi Fortune on the left side. Stays in bounds. Clock continues to move. A pickup of 4 on that first down play. Now they're going to call timeout. Head coach Howie DeCristofaro.
Well, they got 3 timeouts. Now they got 2 left, so no need for them to feel like they have to rush. 50 seconds. Now Cherokee has to go over there and say, hey, we have to not give up the big play. Keep everything in front of you. Don't allow the big play. They've had 2 big plays that led to touchdowns or led to big plays and points on the board. Milton's going to find a way to they're definitely in the kicker's range right now, man.
Yeah, they are.
Right now you got to think, hey, they got at least 3 points.
Ball at the 31-yard line. Now, that would make it, of course, that would make it a 48-yard field goal.
Easy. The way he cleared those first 2 kicks, I wouldn't doubt 48 wouldn't be that hard.
I don't either. Suda already has a 45-yarder. That's his longest of this season. 52 seconds remain here in the first half. Michael Bean, number 34, and the rest of the Warriors defenders need to, as we like to say, bow up their necks.
No doubt about it, right now.
Quick pass, complete to Will Bond. He's got a blocker in front of him. Gets it down inside down to the 20-yard line. Another good-looking play for the Eagle offense, a gain of 11.
And look who's out there blocking, Jake English, the tight end. Coach talked about how well he blocks in the run game. You see him out in open space. It's hard to block a guy in open space when he's got 5-10 yards in front of you.
Pass complete to Nathan Craner. goes out of bounds at the 15-yard line and stops the clock.
We got the Cherokee coaches sitting next to us in the box, and you can hear them yelling. They're not lined up right because they're going so fast. It's tough when you're going against an offense that can move the football and get it to so many different players at one time.
Now second and five for the Eagles. Miko Brisker, the ball carrier. Miko fighting for yards, met head on by Michael Bean, the leading tackler for the Warriors.
27 seconds, they still got plenty of time. They're just outside of the 10-yard line. I believe they still can call whatever they want right here. They got 27 seconds. Even if they pick up a first down,
sure,
the clock will stop. They get to the line of scrimmage, be able to call another play. They got their whole offense open. Even if they want to run the football, they can still run the football with another timeout left. But it's third down, too, so.
You see the offensive coordinator right in the middle of the Milton offense. That's Justin Basile. His second year in that position of OC, his third overall at Milton. Basile has coaching experience at Coffee High School down south and also at Etowah and Sequoia for coming to Milton High. Let's see what he has dialed up for Austin McLeod and the Eagle offense. As DJ mentioned, still a timeout remaining for the Eagles. 27 seconds to go on second and five.
Got him.
McLeod has a receiver caught. Obi Fortune. Touchdown Milton, but a flag has come out. There is a flag on the play. Jerry Kelly is our referee. Gonna be coming back. Beautiful throw by Austin McLeod, right on the money to Obi Fortune, but it is gonna be wiped off the board.
Yeah, well-thrown corner out on the outside by Austin McLeod, but it's all for nothing. It looks like the guilty party might have been number 60 left Austin tackle. Ernest Dye, you saw him talking to the referee.
Why you want to call out a kid teenager like that?
Hey.
Why you want to call
it, him? It happens. It happens.
Get
it happens.
Used to it. Hey, if you're guilty, you're guilty, baby.
If it happens, it happens, baby. You just say, you got to move on to the next play.
So 22 seconds remain here in the first half. Penalty has backed up the Eagles all the way to the 29-yard line. Brisker able to break free, breaking free from Michael Bean and finally taken down as he gets it to the 25-yard line. And Milton here will burn their third and final timeout of the first half.
Yeah, I think they want to run the clock all the way down and then stop it with about 2 seconds to go on the clock and kick the field goal.
That's what Howie DeCristofaro, now the coach, will call timeout with 3 seconds to go here in the first half to once again create another scoring opportunity for his kicker, Ethan Suda. Line of scrimmage is at the 25-yard line, so they'll put the ball down at the 32, which will make it a 42-yard field goal opportunity for Suda.
South Carolina education, baby. Look at that. Add it up.
I just rattled it off. Didn't I? I mean, there was no hesitation.
Didn't even
whatsoever.
Think about that, right?
It's really amazing. Thank you very much. Have you ever been around another football head coach that is so obsessed with the weight room as DeCristofaro is?
Hey, he believes in it, and you know, you got to look at the production they've had tonight. It's all working. We saw Miko Brisker run over a kid near the 15-yard line. I mean, his kids are strong. He believes it makes them explosive, and they all look the part as well. So you got to believe what he's doing is actually working here.
Absolutely. DeCristofaro in his fifth year, they've gotten better every year. Coach Howie's first year, 4-7, then they went 7-4, 8-3, and now 4-1. Looking for their third straight winning season. Milton High School hasn't done that since the early 90s.
Got a little freeze off going on right here. My coach showing the other side, trying to freeze him. Trying to make him think about it, but the way this guy kicks the football.
I don't think you're going to freeze him, bro. No, sir.
No doubt about it.
at every home game here at the Eagles Nest.
Here's a look at the kicker, number 12, Ethan Suda. Already has two field goals on the night, a 40-yarder and a 26-yarder.
A proud supporter of the Milton Football Eagles.
This one, if they ever let these guys play again, will be a 42-yarder.
As well as Saturday.
That's pretty good for a junior field goal kicker in high school.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing him kick this football. He's done a good job of getting it up. I'm sure Cherokee wants to block it or hope he misses it. But I want to see him kick this football.
Final play of the first half. Oh, my goodness. Do you really need to blow another whistle? They've already burned their final timeout, Mr. Referee.
There hasn't been a rule against calling consecutive timeouts to freeze the kicker.
I thought they established that rule a couple of years ago. Oh, no, that was
the
NFL.
It got to be on the next level.
I mean, I've only got so much material here. Right?
You just got to let him go,
I don't
man.
Need to go into my third half material box, DJ.
So if he goes in and just smashes this kick and he makes it, it's like, for what? It means nothing, right?
He'll be right in the face of head coach Josh Shaw of Cherokee.
Well, at least he has no more, right?
That is correct, sir.
In Roswell, Alpharetta coming in surrounding areas as the premier HVAC and air quality professionals. Air Control is a proud sponsor of the Milton Eagles football team.
This second Friday in October feels a little bit more like early September. That weather last weekend was so nice.
It was. It's been nice around here.
Okay, I think we're finally going to be able to give Suda the kicking opportunity. Not quite as powerful, but still accurate. His third field goal of the first half. And Milton ends the first half with another scoring play to increase their lead to 23 points over the Warriors of Cherokee. ...23-0 here at halftime at Milton High School. As you look at Ethan Suda heading to the locker room after three field goals. This is not what I expected. I expected this Cherokee offense. Excuse me. I was getting kind of choked up and just disappointed. But I was expecting this offense to really light it up here.
Yeah, I expected the same thing, especially you look at the stat line, you look at everything that they've done this season, what Spencer Ashley has done, what Andrew Harris has done. It's just been a total domination of Milton. But I think it starts up front. They have definitely established the line of scrimmage up front, both sides of the football, offense and defensive line, and done a good job.
Absolutely. Hats off to the Eagles, all Milton throughout the first half. Don't forget now, Zach Klein and Michael Carvel will be talking about recruiting coming up right after the break, and more good news for the Georgia Bulldogs, which makes him happy. Our score at halftime, 23-0, Milton all over the Warriors.
Jones, Jillian Morris, James Hughes, Nigel Moss, Emily Rowley, and Michael Springer. Special thanks to the MHS art teacher, Mara Haslett, and the National Art Honor Society students for helping create the band's field props currently entering the field. The band is pleased to perform their 2014 production entitled On Cloud Nine, featuring clarinet soloist Bo Quintana, trumpet soloist Andrew Michael, and soprano saxophonist Joseph Simpson. In honor of Senior Night and the class of 2015, the 31 senior marching band members can be seen on the field wearing a red feather plume or a beret instead of the traditional white one tonight by the rest of the group. See if you can spot them on the field. Congratulations, seniors. Drum majors, is your band ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the Milton High School Marching Band!
Thank you.
watching and includes Ollie Brooks, Ansley Kent, Jonathan Kochick, TJ Trumpet, Sean Oren, Oscar Prado, Melissa DeMonte, Winsell, and Bud Bolsby. Assistant band director is John Herndon, and director of bands, Chris Schumann. Let's do it.
Fans, Northside Hospital is your community partner throughout North Fulton County and is your health care sponsor for the Milton Eagles. Northside wishes all Milton Eagle teams a great and healthy season. That's Northside Hospital. Fans, Chick-fil-A at Windward is a proud supporter of Milton football and is now providing fresh Chick-fil-A sandwiches at every home game. Chick-fil-A wishes all Milton Eagle teams a great season. And fans, life is short. Eat better pizza. Jets Pizza is a proud supporter of Milton football and it's available at every home game. Jets Pizza wishes all Milton Eagles and their families a great season. Let's get Jets. Under Armour is proud to outfit Milton football in the world's best performance uniforms, footwear, and apparel. See Under Armour's full range of performance gear at UA.com. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the center of the field. As part of our 10-year anniversary of the new Milton High School and Stadium, we would like to honor Sonny Hawkins, who was the Milton Eagles PA announcer for an incredible 25 years at the old Milton High School Stadium, which was named after him by Fulton County. Mr. Hawkins was a coach, a teacher, and a counselor at the old Milton High School. Let's give Sonny Hawkins a warm welcome back to the Eagles Nest, and we might just get to hear his voice on the PA a little later tonight. Big wave to Sonny out there. Thank you, sir. Fans, drive like a champion. Palmer Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Ram. Palmer Dodge is proud to serve the area with quality Dodge, Jeep, and Chrysler vehicles. Located on Highway 9, Palmer Dodge is your full-service dealer. Palmer Dodge is Scott Strong and a proud supporter of Milton High School football. Go Eagles, and go Palmer Dodge. And you can play like a champion with Resurgence Orthopedics. Conveniently located on Hembry Road with Resurgence Orthopedics, you can restore your health, energize your body, and get back in winning motion. Resurgence Orthopedics, Atlanta's largest orthopedic practice. Resurgenize. Like to thank Golden Corral, they're proud supporters of the Milton Eagles. Golden Corral's legendary endless buffet features an abundant variety of delicious familiar favorites and continuous new menu offerings for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Visit Golden Corral on North Point Parkway. Providing outstanding veterinary services throughout Alpharetta and Roswell, North Roswell Veterinary Clinic, located on Highway 9, provides full service care for your cat or dog and is a great supporter of Milton Eagle football. Like to thank Atlanta Concrete Staining and Creekview Pressure Washing for washing our stadium's inner circle area. Visit them on the web at AtlantaConcreteStaining.com and CreekviewPressureWashing.com. And Roasters. Roasters has a casual, family-friendly atmosphere, serving home-style comfort food for the last 20 years. Tastes like home, feels like home. Closer to home, that's Roasters. Also like to recognize Solar View Photography, creating stunning senior portraits and amazing original sports art for your superstar. Solar View Photography, serving the North Fulton area for more than a decade. Experience the difference. Solar View Photography, your story as art. Also, Harry Norman Realty, Atlanta's oldest and largest residential real estate firm. Let Mandy Thompson or Donna Aguello help you with your real estate needs.
Hey, I hear my...
Whether you're looking to buy or sell, Harry Norman Realtors is here to help you. And Michelle Coulter Salon. They offer a refreshing modern take on classic hair with a relaxing open atmosphere and classic customer service. Michelle Coulter Salon has a team of award-winning stylists with the vision and talent to meet your hair needs. MedPost Urgent Care offers comprehensive urgent care services. Are you looking for a convenient walk-in clinic offering high-quality care? Come experience premier urgent care at MedPost. Located in North Alpharetta on Atlanta Highway. MedPost Urgent Care. Aubrey Orthodontics is passionate about your orthodontic care. Dr. Aubrey's team is dedicated to the personal needs of each patient. Our goal is to develop a smile that is beautiful, natural-looking, and healthy, supporting the Milton Empire, Aubrey Orthodontics. And finally, Old Blind Dog Irish Pub features upscale pub food coupled with perfect pints. Join us at the Old Blind Dog Irish Pub before and after every home game. Tell your server you're supporting Milton Eagles football, and 10% of the tab will be donated directly to Milton Eagles football. We'll see you at the Old Blind Dog after the game. And fans, when you get home tonight, make sure you tune in to WSP Channel 2 for Sports Zone Friday. The number one rated high school football show returns with the biggest games and the best rivalries. And we'll be broadcasting tonight live from the Eagle's Nest at Milton High School. Sports Zone Friday at 11:20 only on Channel 2. And download the free WSB Channel 2 app or go to WSBTV.com. and watch tonight's game live from your seat on your smartphone. Medical coverage for tonight's game is provided by Robin Kleiman of the Sports Medicine Program. Children's Sports Medicine is consistently ranked among the top pediatric programs in the country. They provide comprehensive services for young athletes by offering the full range of care from diagnosis to treatment, surgery to rehabilitation, as well as preventative care. Fans, Milton Concessions now offers Catered by Butcher's Market barbecue, Chick-fil-A sandwiches, and Jet's Pizza. That's right, at our concession stands. treat the family to a great meal right here at the game.
Back at the Eagles' Nest, almost ready for the second half. And one can only hope for the sake of the Cherokee Warriors, the second half will be a lot better than the first half because they basically failed to exist. And Milton just ran right over. You know, we're talking about all the weightlifting and how it's such a huge part of this football program. Milton, and a big part of that, the main reason for that is their head coach, Howie DeCristofaro. But as you pointed out, I mean, they just dominated the action. They dominated the line of scrimmage. They're moving forward. They're showing their strength.
Yeah, and then you look at Cherokee, and you talk about all the players they got, how many players have caught over 200-300 yards, and their quarterback's thrown for 5,300 yards in his career. But it all starts up front. Like, it doesn't matter how many great athletes you have on the outside. If it doesn't have the guys up front who are blocking, who are tackling, who are pushing the line of scrimmage, it doesn't matter how many great athletes you have because they can't get the ball off. So it's been a great job of them dominating both trenches, and they're doing a good job of it so far. So we'll see if they can finish it in the second half.
Still surprised to see that Andrew Harris hasn't really been involved at all in the Cherokee offense, and he came in as the state's leading receiver both in receiving yards and in number of catches with 53, and he has yet to catch a ball tonight.
It's interesting. I mean, they've definitely taken him away. They haven't done anything special on defense. They've been in a lot of quarters coverage, a lot of man coverage, so they haven't done like any bracket coverage to take him away. They've used their front four to get to the quarterback and not allow him to throw the football down the field. So you got to give all the credit to Milton's defense right now.
Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half and one that was dominated by the home team here at the Eagles' Nest. Of course, the big play of the game, Austin McLeod to Obi Fortune, who got behind the secondary and completed a 66-yard scoring play. And that was – I'm sorry. Go ahead. I didn't set you up. I'm struggling here. I'm trying to catch up. That was Obi Fortune's third TD catch.
Yeah, I mean, he had a big first half. He caught a lot of big passes in there and not a lot of big plays to go for in that first half. I mean, they did some good stuff. What defensively that we talked about, you see the defensive stats here. A lot of penalties for Milton, but they haven't hurt him. But you see the passing yards for Cherokee, which just blows me. 42 passing yards and 22 rushing yards. That's unlike this offense, who's used to putting up big-time numbers. And you talk about coming to this ball game, both quarterbacks throw the football really well, but Spencer Ashley, over 420 yards in two consecutive games.
Right.
Not doing much in this first half, at least.
They came in averaging 308 yards through the air through their first six games. Five of those the Warriors did win. So really pretty stunning numbers so far for the Cherokee offense, and they have not shown up. But again, you got to credit the Milton Eagle defense. They've made some great plays at the goal line on Cherokee's first two possessions, kept them out of the end zone, and then they've just shut them down by dominating the line of scrimmage so far. Ethan Suda will kick it away, and we are underway here for the second half at the Eagles' Nest. And for the third time tonight, Suda kicks the ball out of bounds. So
surprising.
Once again, it'll be good field position for the Warriors as they will get it at their own 35-yard line.
First down.
And we all like referee Jerry Kelly, but he's just getting way too much airtime so far.
I'm looking forward to seeing what happens in the second half, particularly in this first drive for Cherokee. If they can come out and establish themselves, establish the run game, establish the pass game, give Spencer Ashley some time to throw the football. This is a big drive coming out of halftime to determine how this game is going to turn out.
Huge drive. Quarterback Spencer Ashley, as DJ mentioned, two consecutive games with more than 420 yards through the air, and there he keeps it on the option read and picks up 6 yards. On first down, it'll be second and four from their own 41-yard line.
Yeah, impressive first start right there. You got to stay ahead of the chains, especially for Cherokee. They haven't done that well in the first half, but good start on the first down.
Britton Brown, the ball carrier. Left side, he's got some space. Makes a good cut. Now separating himself from the defense. Down the left sideline is Britton Brown, and finally knocked out of bounds inside the five by A.J. Beach.
There's the start you wanted. There's the start you needed if you're Cherokee. Now you give yourself some confidence. Now you understand what you're trying to do. You run the football well. Two big run plays by your veterans on offense. This is the Cherokee offense that I thought we would see in the first and second quarter.
57-yard play for the Warriors all the way down to the four-yard line. First and goal. Ashley looked like he was going to run, then threw it to Montrell Washington, and A.J. Beach was not going to have anything to do with that as he just stopped the play cold.
Well, the indecisiveness right there,
right.
Spencer Ashley got to him right there. He had a chance to run it. He had a chance to throw it. You just got to make that decision, especially down here in the red zone, Banner. Stuff happens so fast. You got to pick one decision and go with it.
Loss of two on that first and goal play. Second and goal from the six. Brown, the ball carrier. Again, they're running it inside. It got them nothing in the first half, and there they go again. Nothing on that play, maybe a yard.
Yeah, everything that they've had success on has been around the corner, around the perimeter, either going right or left. They got to get back to that. They're stretching the defense that way. They got to do a little bit better of doing that, especially in the red zone. But a big third down here. I don't think they can get 3 points. They need seven to keep themselves in this ball game.
I agree.
Third down, Milton. Time to get up and make some noise.
Third and goal for the Warriors from the six-yard line. Play clock running down. Able to get the snap off. Ashley, in and out of the hands of Andrew Harris.
He held that football as long as he could. And it went right through the hands of Andrew Harris. They had a good chance of getting it, but it brings up a fourth down. It looks like they're going for it, keeping the offense on the field. I like the call. I don't think three gets you a lot. It gets you on the board, but you need seven right here. Seven is a must.
Well, Harris was wide open, so you got to consider the idea of them just running the same play or else. Maybe a little toss pitch to Brown, which produced a 57-yard run and got him down here on the doorstep. Fourth and goal for the Warriors. Going to the air. Ashley with the fade toss. He's got a receiver, but knocked away at the last second. Once again, beautiful defense from the Eagles. Lucas Nedza discharging that football from the hands of Montrell Washington.
Oh, what a great play by Lucas. Just dislodging that football right at the end. He had it in his hands, and as soon as he go down, you're going to see him just swipe that football out. That's a great job. This is just a great defensive play to stall him. They just hold him right there on that big fourth down play, giving him that much. Milton has to be excited about that, but Cherokee got something to build on. They moved the football really well. I know they won at seven, and you can see right here at the end, Lucas is going to swipe that ball out right there and get it out. I mean, that's just a great defensive play.
Great defensive play, and also a beautifully thrown ball.
Yeah.
It was right on target.
Yeah, great
from
ball.
Ashley.
Great ball.
So Milton takes over, first and 10 from their own 5-yard line, and there goes Miko Brisker, and finally tackled around the ankles by Cole Daniel.
Carries the football down.
Big gain on first down for Miko Brisker. Pickup of 30 yards.
Look at this nice patient run. Staying behind his blocks, keeping his pad level low, and now showing the speed. Coach talked about he worked on that speed during the offseason. That's a great job of just being patient and running behind your pads. Changing field position already by that.
First and 10 now from the 34. Now it's Turner's turn, and he gets it across the 40-yard line. So the Milton offense picks up right where they left off from the first half, continuing to move forward and produce positive plays.
Yeah, this is the offense that they want to be in. They want to be able to run the football, wear you down, and continue to pick up positive yards on first down. They did that, picking up 7 yards on first down, 7-8 yards. So it's an easy second and two. You can do anything you want right now.
Shotgun snap. McLeod through the hands of Obi Fortune, defender. All over that play, Jack Carroll.
Yeah, good. Nader Kramer has to do a better job of blocking outside. I'm sure they're probably happy that he didn't come down with that catch, but a good job of Bryson Perry, number five right there for Cherokee, fighting through the block and getting into the backfield.
Now it'll be third and two for the Eagles from their own 42. Turner, the ball carrier. Going to be close. depends on the mark. He was hit right in the face
at
the 42-yard line, and that's going to be short of the first down. Turner barely able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. So Milton will have to kick it away, and there's a very positive statement from the Warrior defense.
Big stop here. They needed that. Now they got a chance to get their offense back on the field. Just imagine if they got in the end zone there and had a chance. Now they can have a football back, put this game a little bit closer, but they got to chip away right now. Plenty of time. They just got to chip away.
Ball will be marked at the 35-yard line. And that's where Cherokee will take over for their second possession of the second half. They got it all the way down to the 4-yard line. And was turned away by Howie DeCristofaro's Milton defense.
While at FSU last month as a true freshman.
First and 10 for the Warriors. Brown, the ball carrier. Brown with lots of room. Out to the 45-yard line. Good gain on first down.
Brown running like a man on a mission right now. He's trying to put this team on his back. He saw the huge run he just had previously in the last drive. That was a hard, tough, physical run by Brenton Brown.
First down. Not much there on the right side for Ashley. As we approach the 8-minute mark of the third quarter.
Must have been a little miscommunication right there because offensive lineman just stood up. They didn't even move, and Spencer had to just take off.
And time to make some noise, Milton.
Third and one now for the Warrior offense.
Big third down here for Cherokee. They got to come up with a stop. They got to come up with something here. They got to keep these chains moving. I can't afford to give this football back to Milton.
Ball carrier is Hampton on the right side. Looks like he's got enough for a first down.
There is a flag on the play.
So positive play for the Cherokee offense.
On the tackle, number 53, Marty Horan, and number 14.
And our referee, Jerry Kelly, is continuing to savor the airtime, picking up the flag. Thank you, ref. We appreciate that.
Man, you just hate those. You just hate the.
That'll be enough for a Cherokee Warrior first down.
Right now, we want to tell you that we're joined by a special guest, Muhammad Massaquai, apparently doing some prep work for Sunday's work, checking out some high school football action. He's joined us in the booth up here as we continue to show the Cherokee offense in their second series of the second half. Muhammad, how you doing, man?
Doing great, man. It's always good to come out and see Football Friday Spencer night.
You just can't get enough of the pigskin, right?
Nah, you can never get enough of it, man.
Hey, Mo, don't get too comfortable with this guy over here. This guy is a South Carolina Gamecock.
Let me step away.
Y'all go ahead.
He's all about the Gamecocks.
Yeah, let me step away.
We just put you on air, man. Come on. Ashley on the move for the Warriors. Good cut and gets it down to the 42-yard line.
On the carry.
As we say hello to Muhammad Massaquai right here.
See, there you go. Hey,
hi, Mom.
How y'all doing?
So you heard that WSB was going to be showing this game tonight, and DJ gave you a heads up. You said, well, maybe I'll get some airtime.
You know, good Georgia players have a way of attracting each other. had I known you were here, I probably would have stayed.
Oh, my goodness. That's even more mean than DJ is, and he's rough on me, man.
Man, what you don't know about Mo is used to winning a lot of football games, especially in high school. They did a lot of recruiting down there in North Carolina. They had an outstanding program. Mo, how many championships y'all won down there?
8 in a row. I think we won 109 games straight.
8 in a row, Van Earl.
Where's that now?
Charlotte, North Carolina, Independence High School.
Outstanding. Big defensive stand that time for the Eagles. Quarte Sapp in on that tackle. Denying Brenton Brown. Also, Michael Collins involved in that big stop and a tackle for a loss for the Warrior offense. Now they're going back to their first half tendencies. You've been here the whole game?
I have.
What have you seen from this contest?
Well, they were hot in the first quarter. I think they got away from their game plan.
Talking about Cherokee.
Cherokee, number 8's a really good player. I think they should feature him a little bit more. I also heard that they had the top receiver in the state. I'm not sure got any balls.
Number 10, he hadn't been thrown to at all, but there's Britton Brown again receiving that time instead of running and threatening the first down marker. It looks like he's got enough, so the Cherokee drive will continue. But Andrew Harris.
Mo, check out these stats. 53 catches for 900 yards.
Yeah, how many games have they played?
Six games.
They played six games.
Six games. That's amazing, especially on the high school level. For him to go a whole game up to this point without having to catch is
crazy.
This is very crazy.
And it doesn't look like they're doubling number 10 either.
No. They're just playing quarters coverage on the outside, and it's something they got to do more of, but Milton's doing a good job of running to the football. But they're not finding Andrew Harris at all. It's a tough sled right now. Defensively, they're doing a good job. Mo, what kind of good receiver like that? How do you get him the football? I mean, I know you're the type of guy to be like, throw me the football, but.
I think that's what you have to do. I'm looking at it right now, and there's nobody over the top of him. I think you just get him a catch just to get him involved in the ball game.
There he is on the post pattern, and he finally makes his first catch of the game, loses his hat in the process, and he'll draw the personal foul penalty as well as two flags come in at the end of that play. But he was wide open there.
Better, you see why you should throw this guy the football?
Uh-huh.
Soon as he said they just need to find the football to get it to him, they throw it to him. So.
Yeah, guys want to make plays. Whenever your quarterback knows that you're going to make a play for him, usually the guy goes to you, and whenever he has that much confidence in you, you're going to make a play.
Andrew Harris came in with three games of 10 catches or more, also three games with 200 yards or more receiving. So
they're going to need him to get back in this game.
Absolutely.
So hopefully they go to him a lot more.
Absolutely. We got timeout on the field right now as they sort out the penalties, joined by Muhammad Massaquai. Did I say it right?
Yes.
Why?
He wants to mess it up, trust me. That's all it is.
I know.
He's so against us. When we lost to South Carolina, he did half the telecast talking about the Gamecocks. It was ridiculous.
South Carolina education, though. Right. You can't blame him. You can't blame him.
Man, I'm getting
it's two against one.
It's two against one.
Exactly. Britton Brown taken down for a loss in the backfield. Big tackle that time by Kevin Murphy, number 18, for a loss of 6 yards.
This is where Cherokee struggled all night. Every time they get in the red zone, they stall. They don't do much in the red zone. Mo, if you had a red zone play right now for Cherokee, what would it be? Because they struggle right now.
I wouldn't get cute. Number 8 is having a really good game. I would continue to feature him, especially downhill. And being that what was his name, number 10?
Andrew Harris,
yeah. I'd hit him on something quick just to keep him involved in the game. Whenever you have a playmaker like that, I continue to feature him.
Big pass rush that time. Everybody came in the backfield for the Milton defense, and Spencer Ashley had nowhere to go, got it to Britton Brown at the last second, but still resulted in a loss of 5 yards on the play.
Man, we talked about how good this Milton defense has been, and they tried to run a screen there because they've been so good running upfield. It's a big third down here for this Cherokee offense. I'm not sure if they can overcome this third and long, but they got to get something going. They've been down here 4 or 5 times tonight. Ain't need nothing.
13th play of the drive upcoming, but the last two plays have resulted in a combined loss of 11 yards, and now Spencer Ashley frustrated that the play is not getting in on time, and he had to burn the first of three timeouts here in the second half.
I'd like for Cherokee to take some time to get the quarterback comfortable,
right?
Getting him some quick plays just so he can get in the rhythm. He's been out of rhythm the whole game. That's evident by the fact that this leading receiver hasn't had a ball yet until now. So hopefully they can make some adjustments.
Man, you see, this is a receiver that knows if the quarterback's not comfortable, the receivers can't get the football.
So I'm just surprised you're taking up the position of supporting the receiver so much, because I know you get hassled all the time. Throw me the ball.
Hey,
you're the quarterback that you are.
You want a happy quarterback. Happy quarterback makes your job a lot easier.
There's no receiver in football history that's ever been happy with the quarterback all the time. Come on. Well, you never get the ball thrown to you enough.
A perfect game plan is you're getting the ball every play.
I hear you. Hey, while I got you two guys up here, and DJ, please note that I have been nice and not bringing up the Todd Gurley story, but first, DJ, well, let's go back to the action. When we get another break, we'll talk about that, because this is a huge third down for the Cherokee Warriors. Backed up all the way to the 16-yard line, but it's still third and goal, and again the pass rush coming in. Big number 53, Marty Horan, and it looks like it's going to be a holding call Indeed it is on the Cherokee offense. So while they sort that out, DJ, how about your comment and reaction to the whole Todd Gurley situation?
You know what, it's a tough situation. As Mo can tell you, we've been around guys like that all the time. You never know who's going to be who's a snake, who's the guy who's really about, wants to get your autograph. As you see, you got the personal foul there, the holding call. But it's a tough spot for Todd Gurley to be in. I mean, nobody can really say what kind of pressure he's under. I mean, nobody's ever been up for the Heisman like that. And, I mean, he got so many eyes looking at him. Just it's bad that he got caught in this situation. And, you know, from a former player, it's tough. It's tough to see it happen, to my dogs at least.
I think it's unfortunate. Rules are rules, but I think in this case the rules are very outdated.
They sure are.
And whenever you have a guy like Todd Gurley that's constantly being targeted by various people, you never know, like DJ said, who's loyal and who wants an autograph. Hopefully, whenever the dust settles, you know, his name's not in the mix of something that you know, would be suspension worthy.
So on a 4th and 23, Ashley throws it up for grabs, basically. Harris was the closest receiver, and it looks like Harris has been able to draw a pass interference from the Milton defense, which will give them brand new life inside the 5.
You can see the replay here. Spencer does a good job of just getting his football off. But I'm not sure where the PI comes in at. Both guys, all guys are fighting for the football. And I don't know if it happened before that. But possibly it came at a bad time for Milton, but an even greater time for Cherokee.
Indeed it is. Pass interference against Milton. Their first really big mistake of the game. And there you see Howie DeCristofaro, head coach of the Eagles. Of course, he's not happy with that call. But it'll be Warrior football, 1st and 10. Inside, it'll be fourth. I'm sorry, it'll be fourth down. But they're certainly a lot closer to the goal line after the penalty. It'll be fourth down from the 11-yard line of Milton.
I'd love to see him just throw a jump ball to Andrew Harris right here. Just give him a chance to make a play.
Harris split out wide on the right side, part of the trips formation. Ashley looking for him. Ashley trying to avoid the rush, and he loses the football, and it's recovered by the pass rusher. Beautiful play. Number 98, Tyler Watson for the complete to Nate Craner on the left side, trying to use the block of Will Bond, picked up a couple of yards.
Mo, I can't believe you said 15 to 20. Come on.
15 to 20 years.
I just left in 06. Come on, golly.
What is that? That's what?
It's like 9 years. Not 15. God.
Well, I'm not even going to talk about my age. Forget that. All right, it's going to be 3rd and 5 now for the Milton Eagles, trying to turn the fumble into points. Quarterback Austin McLeod, joined in the backfield by Miko Brisker. Play fakes to Brisker. Hits his tight end, Jake English. coming out on the right side, and English gets it close to the 40-yard line.
Been a total offensive dominance from Milton. They're doing everything they want right now. They're able to run the football, throw it. They sneak the tight end out all night. Jake English done a good job of catching the football and then doing something after the catch. This is an offense that's working on all cylinders, running the football, throwing the football. They have everything clicking.
It's really exciting when you see an offensive coordinator take what's given to him. I think a lot of times coordinators get a little too cute. Mm-hmm. And it's refreshing to see this guy just taking the game as it comes to him.
What kind of offense y'all ran out there in Independence? I know y'all threw it around. I know Redhead, Mr. Joe Cox. I know y'all threw it around. So cute and taking what they give you is nothing what they talk about at Independence.
No,
I know you had crazy numbers when you came to Georgia.
It's completely different. Our mentality was score. The defense was there to stop. We were there to score.
Now he's talking about it. I like it when it's cute. Yeah. But when he played, score.
Yeah, it was cute to score.
There you go. Chris Turner, the ball carrier. He'll be dropped for a loss by Michael Bean, the leading tackler for the Cherokee defense. How much fun was that to be a part of? You said 10 – a school that had 10 straight state championships?
Nine
straight. Yeah. I mean, that had to be so much fun.
It was a lot of fun. But whenever you're at the top, somebody's always gunning for you. So we always had to come out and play, and that was the exciting challenge.
That's right. That keeps you sharp, though.
It kept us very sharp.
Big-time program out there, man. They produce a lot of big-time players at that high school, Ben Earl.
Third and nine for the Eagles. McLeod looking to throw. Chased out of the pocket. Picks up positive yards, gets it into Cherokee territory before finally taken down by Michael Bean. Good enough for another first down, a gain of 14 yards on the play.
And this is part of the game we didn't talk about with Austin McLeod. We talked about him being a manager, being able to control the clock, but he did a good job there of using his legs to make an extra play. And as the third quarter winds and we get to the fourth quarter, I want to thank my boy Muhammad for coming by, stopping through for a minute. We got some of our huge fans here showing why Muhammad's here. So we appreciate him stopping by in the booth and tagging the team in on this Gamecock over here.
Absolutely. Well,
I would say you're in good hands, but you have a South Carolina guy. But you're in good hands with Shock over here.
I hear you. Muhammad Massaquai, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for having me.
And have a great rest of the season as well. Right, we're through three quarters, and it's all Milton 23-0 here on WSBTV.com. Once again, Austin McLeod has the Milton offense on the move. Miko Brisker, the ball carrier, still on his feet, fighting for yards. Got it across the 45-yard line, but yet another flag comes flying in after the play.
Yeah, this is going to be on Milton. They got a little extracurricular, a little extra at the end of the play, as offensive linemen do. You ask them to be on the edge, but not all the way over the edge, and he was a little bit over the edge on that play.
You gonna charge us a booking fee for getting our guest up here to join us?
I talked that over to our producer, Stephen Lawler.
Yes.
He can hear me right now, so.
Yes.
We'll get that together with Stephen.
Stephen says, I want part of that booking fee.
Nah, Ben Halpern did a good job of letting us know. Mo Mass is what I call him, was in the building. And good to have him up. Always good to see another dog and get on you a lot, so I enjoy that.
I can't, you know, y'all are just ruthless double teaming me like that. You see the Milton students decked out in their purple because they're trying to raise awareness for pancreatic cancer. Another flag on second down.
Flag on the play. It's going to be a procedure call against
Muhammad, also talking with us about how big high school football is becoming. It is growing to me a lot on an everyday basis.
You talked about it growing, and earlier we talked about how freshmen are going into college and how they're playing right away, and I think it's a true test because of they're ready when they get there. These coaches do a good job of teaching them. They got so many camps. They got so many things they can get to. These kids are ready once they get to the next level, which allows them to play earlier.
Absolutely. I mean, it's becoming a business even now on the high school level. So after the penalty, it's second and 21 for the Eagle offense, and now a timeout called by Howie DeCristofaro as well as their offensive coordinator, Justin Basile. Milton came into this game with twice as many run yards as passing, 1,099 on the ground, 512 through the air, but they have shown a very balanced attack tonight, DJ, and also a very productive attack.
Milton's done a good job, and yeah, I got to look on the other side of the ball in Cherokee's defense, and when we talked to Coach Shaw about it this week, he talked about they wanted to eliminate the big plays. They haven't done that. They've given up some couple of big plays in this game. They want to keep everything in front of them. And they haven't done that. They had a couple big plays down the field we talked about in the first half, and then coming out in the second half, Milton's done a good job. And they haven't been able to get – Cherokee Demons hasn't been able to get to the quarterback tonight at all. And so he's had a good night sitting in the pocket. He's had a good chance of, you know, making good decisions. So
and
he's done a good job tonight. Austin McLeod, you got to give him credit.
McLeod looking to throw again. Instead, tucking and running, picking up positive yards. Has a long way to go on second and 26, but at least he's heading in the right direction. I tell you, the Cherokee pass rushers have not gotten to McLeod. They're number 11 in blue, but boy, have the Milton pass rushers gotten to Spencer Ashley. I mean, they have been in the backfield all night long.
Yeah, you got to get the big horses right there. You see the big horses up front. And Layden Weatherby, 78. Noah Nutter, number 70. Tyler Perry, 68. Nick Wilson, 51. Ernest Dye, 60. They've done a good job of opening holes all night for Milton.
Jet sweep to Obi Fortune. Not a whole lot there. Gets it close to the 45-yard line, but they have to get into Cherokee territory and all the way down to the 38 for a first down. And now it's a little extracurricular going on out there.
I'm sure Milton don't mind, though. As long as the clock's still running and you see Obi going after the guy, he's saying he pulled on his neck. So he's a little overexcited right now because they got this game clearly in hand, but he's still fighting. Looks like he's saying somebody pulled at his neck, and he's extremely mad about it, as you can see.
So only the third punt of the game for Milton here early in the fourth quarter. Ethan Suda, not only with the strong leg on field goals, but a strong leg on punts as well. Good high kick, backing up Washington, who bobbles it and finally recovers it. But good coverage by the punt team of Milton as well.
We'll be right back.
done much offensively. Had a couple catches here in the ball game, but not the dynamic night he's had for the past couple weeks.
Correction, first down.
They've corrected it. It's now first and 10. First and 10 for the Warrior offense. Ashley over the middle, caught by Harris. His second catch of the night. A good gain and good enough for a first down, but yet another, no, not another flag. They're just going to stop to move the sticks. A gain of 13 on that play on Harris's catch.
Good job of finding Andrew Harris. Got the one-on-one matchup. You find him. Good job of Spencer Ashley standing in there and throwing the football.
Line of scrimmage at the 25. Ashley rolling to his left. And will step out of bounds, but pick up 4 or 5 yards on the play.
Nothing wrong with that. Even if you got out of bounds, you stopped the clock, you turned a nothing play into a positive play. Spencer's starting to do a little bit better here in this fourth quarter. You got to wonder if it's too little too late, but they still got 9 minutes to go to try to get some stuff on the scoreboard here.
Plenty of time. I don't think it's they can get a touchdown on this drive. They definitely got a chance because they have the ability to strike quickly. Reverse to Harris. Ashley, the quarterback out there blocking. Harris looking for some running room. Still on his feet and getting it out to the 35-yard line. And should be good enough for another first down. Indeed it is. They move the sticks down the field. Cherokee staying ahead of the chains for once on their on an offensive series.
When it's tough getting it to him in the air, you just got to find all ways to get him the football. They came with the reverse there just to get the football in his hands. That's something you got to do. Maybe something they should have tried a little bit earlier, but I don't mind them trying it now.
First and 10, big pass rush again by the Milton front line, and Ashley has to go down. Loses two on the play. Andrew Harris, number 10. As you mentioned, DJ, just trying to get the ball in his hands, and why not? I mean, he's really developed physically over the last year. He's also the Cherokee County champion in the long jump and 200 meters. We've talked about the amazing numbers he's put up receiving the football this football season. He only had 20-something catches last year, and what he's been doing so far this year is definitely going to put him on the radar of the recruiters. Ashley over the middle and caught. Complete to Dante Baker right at the 45-yard line. Another positive play for the Warrior offense.
Now Spencer's having a chance to sit in there and throw the football. You can see why he's thrown for a lot of yards the past couple weeks because he's had a little time when he does. One thing I want to see Spencer do, though, if he gets a little pressure and he's able to get away from it, keep his eyes down the field. Sometimes you see him take his eyes away and he thinks about running right now. If he keeps his eyes down the field for another half a second, he can probably throw it to somebody else.
First and 10 from their own 46. Ashley complete to Harris at the 50, but another flag comes out on the play.
Ashley's pass is complete to number 10, Andrew Harris. Holding. Making the tackle, number 3, A.J. Beach. Flag on the play.
As we were talking about Andrew Harris, head coach Josh Shaw, expressed his surprise that he has not been more or recruited more heavily than he has. But again, this has been a breakout season for him, and he is a senior this year. And you see what he's been doing so far this football season, and a heck of a track athlete as well. He's caught 10 TD passes. He's run for a TD. He's picked off an interception and returned that for a touchdown, and he's also thrown a touchdown for the Warriors, but hadn't been able to score tonight. In and out of the hands that time of Dante Baker.
Harris is an accomplished guy. He's done some good things for his team this year. He's definitely been the catalyst for why they're in the position they're in. Tonight they run up on a Milton defense that's been pretty tough, but they're still trying to find ways to get him the football. It's just a night where things just didn't go your way for the most part.
Incompletion stopped the clock. 7.5 minutes to go in the contest. Big pass rush. Ashley able to stay on his feet and scramble and get out to the 41-yard line. Good play by Ashley that time because, once again, no protection from his big boys up front.
Yeah, it's been a tough night for him, and Spencer's going to he's going to rest good tonight because he's going to be good and tired because they've been running after him and chasing him all night long. But I like the way he's fighting. He's continued to fight. He's a little tired now. You see him a little bent over, but he still continued to try to make some plays for this unit.
Steinhaus and Murphy teaming up for that tackle of Ashley. Third and 14. Finally caught, brought in by Colton Rosansky, a senior wideout, his 20th catch of the season.
Hey, it don't matter if you catch it one, two, three, four times. It counts as one time, but a good job of landing in the hole. Good touch pass and a great concentration by Colton Rosansky to hold on to the football.
Very good concentration. But that time, DJ, he must have heard you because he did keep his eyes downfield.
Absolutely. You can hear me yelling up here. I'm all about good QB play. And for the most part, he's done it. Just hadn't had the time to throw the football down the field. And that's not his fault. You know, offensive line has had a tough time tonight. This is a good defensive unit for Milton.
Having Muhammad Massaquoi up here in the booth with us and talking about how receivers can't get the ball enough, you had to get tired of that sometimes in the meetings. Because you know that, I'm imagining they were always hassling you, get me the ball.
All wideouts think they're open on every single play. And it doesn't matter if it's first down, second down. We may run the football and they say, that guy can't cover me.
Another long drive for the Warriors. About to be the 11th play of this drive. Fourth and inches. Going to give it to Brown. No, Ashley kept it himself. Good fake. Looking for room. Getting blocking from his running back, Britton Brown. Ashley going to the end zone. And he fumbles right at the goal line, and it's going to be Milton football, a touchback for the Eagles. Oh, my goodness.
Now, that is beyond crazy. Make a spectacular run, spectacular play to get all the way to the end zone.
Wow.
And you fumble it on the 1 yard line. Let's see if he actually got into the end zone.
Great
before
fake.
He fumbled here.
Great fake.
At the last moment, you can see him just good job of running the football. The last possible moment.
A.J. Beach.
Oh, yeah, that ball is definitely out. That ball is definitely out as he tries the last leap into the end zone. Oh, what a play. What
wow.
A play by A.J. Beach. Never giving up on the play. Just knocking it out the end of the play. You see number 3, A.J. Beach, there getting all the love from the fellas on the sideline.
Well, he deserves it, man. That was a great hustle play. Wow. Not sure it can get much worse for that team with the white jerseys and red pants. The visitors from Cherokee County, 16 miles away. And Milton takes over with 6-plus minutes to go. And the ground game is their thing, and that's what they're going to do right now and just grind away at this clock. Watching Inside the NFL this week and talking about or listening to Boomer Esiason talk about there's nothing more satisfying, not just for an offense, but especially for the big guys up front, the offensive line, to put away an opponent with the ground game in the final minutes of the fourth quarter when you got a lead.
They live for it. Trust me, I've been in offensive meetings where the offensive line can sit there and watch the four-minute drill and just sit there and smile because they feel like they dominated the guy in front of them by running the football.
Chris Turner, the ball carrier, lots of space out beyond the 25. He'll get it to the 27-yard line.
You hit it on the head, though. This team in white was kind of dominated tonight. They wanted to come in and have another signature win versus a quality opponent, and it just wasn't for them tonight. And Milton's going to take that streak up to 6 now. This is a very, very good Milton team, and I was very impressed defensively by what they did tonight to stop a very, very good Cherokee offense.
Really good defensive performance for Howie DeCristofaro's Milton Ball Club tonight. And this will put them in the driver's seat of their region battle. They came in a half game out of first place, I should say. Oh, Miko Brisker loses his helmet for the third time tonight on a running play. That man needs to adjust his chin strap.
Hey, look at that guy. He's a tough guy. Look at there. No scratch, no bruise, none. He probably wants to play without a helmet.
He probably does. We mentioned his terrific abilities in the weight room. Bench presses 415, squats 645. The flag against Woodstock. Woodstock, where am I? Man, I don't even want to know the answer to that question. The flag against Cherokee. Sometimes I really don't know why my brain operates the way it does. The penalty puts the football in line of scrimmage in Cherokee territory. So as we mentioned.
I think you're still just bewildered by how you just got ran over by two dogs.
I think so.
I think that's still on your mind.
I think I'm recovering. I'm still a little woozy. Ball carrier is Chris Turner. Picks up a couple. Back up the middle. We've seen some good football teams this season so far, DJ. And Milton has been very impressive tonight. Alatoona, we saw a couple of weeks ago. They've got an outstanding running attack with Russell Holloman and Josh Batista. These guys with Miko Brisker and Chris Turner. Another 1-2 punch when it comes to a couple of running backs. And
we've been blessed. We've been blessed to see some quality games and also some great players throughout the region, throughout the state. Some great coaches doing some good things. It's been a good, successful year already, and plenty more to come.
Flag on the play. Hey, once again, a reminder.
Illegal procedure
up here in the press box. Somebody's lost
against Milton. That'll back him up 5 yards. And we want to remind all of you to turn over to Channel 2 later on tonight at 11:20 for the Friday night Channel 2 Sports Zone. DJ joining Zach and Anthony for all the best highlights. And here's a look at Region 5 of Class 6A. And these are the records coming into tonight's action. But as you see, Cherokee will fall out of that first place tie. And Milton will move into first place as their record, region record, will improve to 3-1. Chris Turner, the ball carrier, and another flag. I'm so excited when I see flags.
I can just tell. I mean, you get so energetic when you see the laundry on the field.
You know what? I made a mistake. There was no flag on that play, so I'm very thankful for that. It's the little things. Less than three to go here in Alpharetta. We've had our own sideshow up here because we're next to the Cherokee coaches box, and we've heard some entertaining comments throughout their night of frustration. Miko Brisker toting the pig and still on his feet. Look at Miko push the pile and still fight for yardage. And he loses his hat again. I mean, they really need to get him a double snap chin strap, Rob.
I mean, he is carrying all 11 white jerseys for an extra 5-6 yards.
At least.
I just know that helmet doesn't want to stay on.
It doesn't. 17 yards on the play.
Well,
DJ,
just watch after contact how many yards he gets. There's contact right there. So now we're going another. There's 5 yards. There goes another 6, 7 yards. I mean, this
13,
is
13, maybe even 14 yards after
initial
contact.
I think the only reason why he went down was his helmet came off. That's the only reason I think he stopped fighting.
I think he got tired carrying all those humans. He does have a double strap chin strap, and it still can't stay on. Another first down for the Eagles, approaching the 2-minute mark of the fourth period as Milton just tries to run out the clock, leading 23 to nothing. Milton came in ranked 8th in the state in Class 6A in the AJC high school poll, also ranked as high as 5 in another poll. And there you see the other schools. I mean, South Georgia has been getting it done this year.
We saw Grayson. They were pretty impressive when we saw them rolling.
Very impressive sophomore quarterback. Last week we were
DeCula.
At DeCula.
Yep.
It's DeCula. Don't forget, DeCula. For our female viewer that made it clear that I was not pronouncing it correctly. There, Brisker is dropped four loss. And on the tackle, number 34, Michael Bean, the leading tackler for the Warrior defense.
Well, this is exactly how they wanted to end the ball game. I think they got the ball with about 6 minutes to go on the clock. And
right.
They definitely run the clock all the way down and just finish this ball game all the way out. Depending on what they do here, they can probably run this clock all the way down. And looks like they called a timeout. Looks like Cherokee might have called a timeout.
Bean shaking up on the far side.
With less than 1 minute left in this game. Hats off to you, Michael Collins.
There he is, Michael Bean, number 34. Came in with 79 tackles, and he's still a little woozy. It was a face-to-face meeting between himself and Brisker on the last play.
That's a tough matchup right there.
Both that
those, both those guys are real heady players. I enjoy watching both of them tonight.
Third down for Milton.
Final minute of play. Next week will be at McEachern High School. Meanwhile, Milton, their game next week is at Walton. Next week, though, for us, it's North Paulding at McEachern. And North Paulding's quarterback leads the state in passing yards. And, of course, McEachern, we've already had a chance to see, they had a great game that they played and lost in the final seconds against Buford High School. Buford continues to dominate. But that is going to do it for us here at Milton High School, where the home team dominated from start to finish, kept the high-scoring Warriors off the board, and win it in shutout fashion, 23-0. Back to wrap it up right after this.
Don't forget those keys, you Mercury owner.
I can hear. What? Hey, how many games have you done?
Whatever. You hear me? Okay, yeah, what you said is fine, but go ahead and roll it when we start talking. Don't wait for the cue. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
The Milton Eagles improved to 5-1. And 3-1 in region play with their shutout victory tonight of the Cherokee Warriors. DJ Shockley, Van are all right. All Milton all night long. Do you have anything to say?
Just a hard-fought game for Milton. Obviously, it didn't turn out how Cherokee wanted. They had high hopes. We talked to Coach on the week, and it just wasn't really exactly what they wanted. They didn't finish. They had red zone issues.
Yep.
They couldn't keep him protected. So, especially Ashley had a tough night.
He sure did. The pass rush from Milton just on cue and on time all night long. Ashley never did really have a chance at all, as DJ mentioned. That great play.
And here's the thing, all these,
the sack and the forced fumble,
all these are near the red zone. So they had chances to score a lot of points and just weren't able to do it. The constant pressure on Spencer Ashley all night was pretty amazing. And you see Brisker. You see him running over guys all night. He ran hard. He ran tough. And he's been a physical player whose helmet only tends to come off five times a game.
This pretty much epitomize the entire night. Brisker, 14 yards after initial contact, and he had a big night running the football. And just it was a display of superior strength and power by Milton. They really just dominated him physically.
They did up front, and I thought it all started with the offense and defensive line. They set the tone early, moving that line of scrimmage from one side to another, whether it's offense or defense. They did everything they wanted to do, and that's why they were able to come out on the win tonight and be able to move the football and stop a very high-powered offense. I mean, we can't understate that. They played a really good football team, and they were not able to really solidify themselves tonight.
Cherokee came in averaging 39 points a game tonight, zero. We want to thank all of you for joining us here for Friday Night Football. DJ will be coming your way on Channel 2 at 11:20 later tonight when he joins Zach Klein and Anthony Amy for the Friday Night Sports Zone with all the best high school football highlights from around the area and, of course, tons of scores. So for DJ Shockley, as well as producer-director Stephen Lawler and our entire hard-working crew, we thank you for sharing part of your Friday night with us. The final score from Milton, the Eagles 23 and Cherokee nothing. I'm Van Earl Wright, wishing you a wonderful weekend.